Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today's talk of the day is the secret to getting ahead is getting started. So whenever you are having something very hard to do, you must divide your work into smaller manageable tasks and then start working on one. It is the only way that you will get ahead, that you have to take a start. We have discussed the structure of atom in our previous lesson. We discussed that everything is made up of matter, and matter can be found in three states. It can be liquid, solid, or gas. In all of these three states, the smallest particle of the matter is atom. And atom can be divided into three subatomic particles. It contains electron that carry negative charge, and these electrons are revolving in the shells around the nucleus. It carry positively charged protons. They are present in the nucleus, and it carry neutral neutrons. It is also located in the nucleus. So in an atom, in the nucleus, proton and neutron are present. Proton carry positive charge, neutron carry no charge. So in total, we can say nucleus is neutral. Whereas electrons are revolving around the nucleus in the shells, and electrons carry negative charge. Today, we are going to study chemical symbols, the definition, and the some of the examples. A chemical symbol is a notation of one or two letters representing a chemical element. The exceptions to the one to two letter symbols are the temporary element symbols assigned to designate new are to be synthesized elements. So simply we can say that chemists use chemical symbols to represent elements and chemical formulas to represent compounds. Chemical symbols are mostly used one or two letters. First letter is always capitalized. Second letter is always a lowercase letter. For example, you can see here helium, magnesium, and manganese. In all of these three elements, the first letter, when we are going to write the symbols of these elements, the first letter is capital, whereas the second letter is a lowercase letter. And we use, for example, H, capital H we use, is a chemical symbol for hydrogen. Capital C is the chemical symbol for carbon. Capital S and small I, it is the chemical symbol for silicon. So we are going to use different chemical symbols to show the elements. Chemical symbols are found on the periodic table and are used when writing chemical formulas and equation. So this is the importance of the chemical symbols, that they are used in the periodic table. In periodic table, we are mostly using the chemical symbols. We are not writing the full names of the elements. And secondly, when we write the chemical formulas and when we write the chemical equations, we use chemical symbols. While the term chemical symbol usually refers to an element symbol. So when we say chemical symbol, it means the symbol of an element. It is mostly the element symbol. There are other symbols used in chemistry. We're going to use so many other symbols as well, but mostly the chemical symbols mean the element symbols, and the element symbol is the name of that element. That is, we are going to use only notation of its full name. Some symbols come from the Latin name. So this is another important thing to remember, that mostly we're going to take the name from its we're going to take the symbol from its name, but there are some of the symbols that we have taken from the Latin name. Latin language is the ancient language, and it is not the national language of any country. So mostly we are going to take we can take some names from the Latin language. For example, here you can see for sodium, we are not writing SO or SD. Instead, we are writing capital N and small a. That is the symbol for the sodium. We have taken this symbol from its Latin name, that is the natrium. Similarly, for gold, we are using the symbol AU, and we have taken the symbol from its Latin name, that is the aurum. For iron, we are not writing like I, O or anything else. We are writing capital F and small e, and we have taken this name from its Latin name, that is the, we have taken the symbol from its Latin name, that is the ferrum. Then there is lead. We use Pb from plumbum. So we can say that chemical symbols are the notations, are the short symbols we use to write instead of writing the full name of the element. These symbols are taken from its name. We can write only one letter, or there can be two letters. If we are writing one letter name, it must be capital. Like for carbon, it's capital C. For sulfur, it's capital S. For writing more than, if it is consisting of two letters, the first letter will be capital and the second letter will be small. For example, here you can see for gold, capital A and small u. For iron, capital F and small e. And we can take the name from its, we can take the symbol from its name, and we can also take the symbol from its Latin name. So this is the rules for writing the symbols. Here you can see some of the elements with their symbols. For example, aluminium, Latin name alumin, we have taken Al. Fluorine, F, it is also from taken from the Latin name. Carbon, then potassium, sodium. So all of these are basically different symbols that we use for the elements. And we can define the chemical symbol as, it is the abbreviation of the name of the element. So what is a chemical symbol? It is basically the abbreviation of the name of the element consisting of one or two letters. For example, the symbol for oxygen is capital O. The symbol for carbon is capital C. And you can see that since C has already been used for carbon, so if we have to make a symbol of the calcium, so we are going to take A along with the C, and we are using the symbol Ca. The second letter is not capitalized. So here you can see it is a very good explanation of what is a chemical symbol. It is an abbreviation of the name of the element. Mostly we are using this symbol for oxygen is O, symbol for carbon is C, and these are the capital letters. And C, if we are going to have taken any alphabet for any symbol, like for example, C has already taken, has already been used for carbon. So for calcium, we have to use some other symbol, and here we are going to use capital C and small a. Here you can see some of the symbols and name of some elements. Number one, hydrogen. For hydrogen, we are using H, and you can see it is the capital H. It is a uppercase letter. For helium, we are using HE, capital H and small e. So uppercase and lowercase letters will be used when we are going to take a symbol, when the symbol will be consisting of two letters. Then first letter will be uppercase and the second will be a lowercase letter. Here you can see lithium, Li, beryllium, Be, boron, B, carbon, C, nitrogen, N, oxygen, O, fluorine, F, neon, Ne. So here you can see this is a list of the different symbols. For example, for sodium, we are going to use Na, and you can see the difference, like why sodium is given a name Na, because this Na is taken from its Latin name that is the natrium. For magnesium, we use Mg. For aluminium, Al. Silicon, Si. For phosphorus, we are only using capital P. For sulfur, we are using only the letter S. Chlorine, as we have already used C for carbon, so we have to, for chlorine, we have to use L as well. So we are writing chlorine, Cl. For argon, potassium, calcium, Ca. Similarly, here you can see chromium, then it will become Cr. So basically, the chemical symbols are the shortest notations, shortest names of the, it is an abbreviation of the name. So but these are now known worldwide, that we are whenever we are going to write any of the formula, or we are going to do any we are going to write any equations, so we use these symbols, and in our periodic table we use these symbols. So you are supposed to learn all of these element names along with the symbols. Here you can see for carbon we use capital C, for neon we use capital N and small e, and for silver we use capital A and small g. So these are the chemical symbols that are used to show the name of the element. Now just recall the rules for writing chemical symbols. The first letter of the symbol is always capitalized. If there is a second letter, it is lowercase. If means that there is a chance that there can be a second letter. As you already know, there are so many of the elements that only have one letter. For example, carbon, and then there are hydrogen. So there are so many elements that have that we are going to use only one letter symbols for them. But if there is an element that we are going to use the second letter for it, it will always be a lowercase. No elements have permanent symbols with more than two letters. So here you can see that this is also a rule for writing chemical symbols, that all the elements, they are having only two letters as a symbols. Okay? Mostly we are going to use only one letter and the two letters for writing the permanent symbols of the elements. The chemical symbol represents one atom of the element. Another thing that we are going to study today is the atomic number. Atomic number, a proton number, we can also call the atomic number as the number of protons or the proton number. We use symbol Z for this. The atomic number of a chemical element is the number of protons found in the nucleus of every atom of that element. So what is the atomic number? Atomic number of an element is equal to the number of protons present in the nucleus of its atom. So all the different number of the protons that is present in the nucleus of the element is known as atomic number. It is identical to the charge number of the nucleus. If an uncharged atom, the atomic number is also equal to the number of electrons. The sum of the here the important thing to note in that the symbol we use for atomic number is Z. This capital Z is used as a symbol for showing the atomic number. And what is meant by atomic number? The number of protons in the nucleus of an element is known as atomic number. Here, for example, you can see the atomic number of hydrogen is 1. So we can simply write Z is equal to 1. What is meant by this? The atomic number. And what is meant by atomic number? Atomic number means the number of protons. It means that a hydrogen is having one proton in its nucleus. So hydrogen is having only one proton in its nucleus. That is the reason it is having atomic number 1. Here you can see a list of different elements with their atomic number. What is meant by atomic number? The number of protons. So this list shows how many protons are present in different elements. For example, in hydrogen, the atomic number is 1. It means that hydrogen is having 1 proton. in its nucleus. Helium atomic number is 2, means helium is having 2 protons in its nucleus. For lithium, the atomic number is 3. It have 3 protons in its nucleus. For boron, the atomic number is 5. So it have 5 protons. So this is the number of protons that are present in different elements, nucleus of different elements. So what is the number of protons for sulfur? Find out from the list. Yes, the atomic number of sulfur is 16. It means it have 16 protons in its nucleus. Now tell me, what is the atomic number of oxygen? Yes, the atomic number of oxygen is 8, that it is having 8 protons in its nucleus. So this list shows the atomic number of different elements of the periodic table, and this atomic number is basically telling us that how many protons are present in the nucleus of that element. Next, we will do the mass number. There is a difference in the atomic number and mass number. The sum of the atomic number and the number of neutrons, that is abbreviated as capital N, gives the mass number of an atom. So what is the mass number? It is the sum total of Z and N. Z is the atomic number, N is the neutron number. So if we are going to plus Z and N, it will give us A, that is the mass number. So the sum of the atomic number Z and the number of neutrons N gives the mass number of an atom. Since protons and neutrons have approximately the same mass, and the mass of the electrons is negligible for many purposes, and the mass defect of nucleon binding is always small compared to the nucleon mass. So basically we can say that atoms with the same atomic number, we can say that mass number can be defined as the sum of the protons and neutrons in the nucleus of an atom. Using the mass number is the only way to find the number of neutrons. So here you can see, for carbon atom, the atomic number is Z. It means it has, and it is 6. It means it has 6 protons in its nucleus. Whereas the mass number is known as A. Here we have written the mass number at the top. Usually we are going to write it like this. Like here you can see 6 and 14. Here at the bottom we write atomic number, and at the top we are going to write the mass number. So if atomic number is 6 and mass number is 12, it means atomic number means the number of protons. Mass number means we have added protons and neutrons. There is another important thing that we should remember, that some of the elements are having same atomic number but they have different mass number. The same element have same atomic number, but for example for carbon, we will see here, you can see two different isotopes of the carbon. In this one, carbon is having atomic number 6, whereas mass number 12. It means that it is having 6 proton, and if we want to calculate the mass number, 6 are protons, and then definitely the rest of the 6 are neutrons, because mass number is the number of the protons, sum of the protons and neutrons in an element. Here in the second isotope of the carbon, you can see it is written 6 and 14. It means that it is having 6 protons. 14 means it is having 8 neutrons in its nucleus. So these are known as isotopes. What is meant by an isotope? Isotope means these are different carbons. They're different, you can say, types of carbon that have different isotopes of the carbon that have the same atomic number, but they have the different mass number. Here you can see both of the isotopes of the carbon. In the first one, it is having 6 and 12. Atomic number is 6 and mass number is 12. Which means it have 6 proton and it have 6 proton and 6 neutron, whereas here it is a isotope of the carbon which has 6, 14. 6 are the number of protons and 14 means it has 6 protons whereas 8 neutrons. So these are the different isotopes of the carbon, but here we basically just want to focus on what is the mass number, and the mass number is the sum of the protons and neutrons in the nucleus of an atom. Why we have given you a concept of the isotopes of carbon? Because we want to know you that there are different types of carbon atoms. There are different isotopes of carbon, so that you must have a clear idea that what is meant by a mass number. It is the total of the proton and the number of neutrons. We can use this formula for finding the mass number. The number of neutrons plus number of protons is equal to the mass number. We can have a comparison between the atomic number versus the mass number. Atomic number is the number of protons present in an atom, whereas the mass number is the sum of the number of protons and the neutrons of an atom. It is not affected by number of neutrons, whereas the mass number, it is affected by the number of neutrons. If we are going to summarize our today's lesson, we have discussed that different elements can be abbreviated by using some of the abbreviations of their name. We use different symbols to abbreviate the name of the chemicals, and these are known as chemical symbols. For example, we use capital H for hydrogen, we use capital C for carbon, we use capital O for oxygen. So these are the symbols we used to show the name of the element, and mostly we are going to use this symbol in periodic table and for writing the chemical formulas and chemical equations. Then we have discussed what is the difference between an atomic number and mass number. Atomic number is the number of protons in an atom, whereas the mass number is the sum of protons plus neutrons in an atom. So atomic number is the number of protons, whereas mass number is the number of protons and neutrons in an atom. In case of the atomic number, it is not affected by number of neutrons. For atomic number, it only depends on the number of neutrons, so we can say it is not affected by the number of neutrons, whereas in case of the mass number, it is affected by the number of neutrons. So this is all from our today's lesson. Do your test yourself related to this topic on your NEET copies.